People generally come to me for personal branding, okay? That's what I specialize in. And they come to me for jobs in the Middle East because I was there for 40 plus years. The one thing I've noticed is, the biggest thing, is when people apply for jobs, they never use their fucking common sense. They just don't use, okay? I'll give you a couple of examples. This guy, he went down to Dubai, applied for jobs left, right, and center. And, you know, then finally he got in touch with me. And I always ask people, I always interact with them, what did you do? What was your strategy? What is your CV? What is your salary? I try to understand what is it that they are doing before I even recommend solutions. What this guy did was, he got in touch with one of those online, you know, service providers, freelancers. Paid a sum of money, and the guy said he would send his CV to 500,000 companies in the Middle East. 500,000, huh? So I asked him, what was the email that you sent? And he showed me the format. In the format was the typical fucking response. Dear sir slash madam, I hereby present my resume for your kind perusal. I have so many years experience. I'm looking for this kind of job, looking forward for an appointment with you, or I'm available at so-and-so, my contact details. I was like, don't you know that this is a fucking copy paste, that everyone sends this fucking letter? He was like, yeah, I know that, but I was hoping someone would open the email. Open the email and do fucking what? And his CV was fucking crap. Absolute fucking ridiculous. From the photograph, which looked like, you know, he just took it from his fucking iPhone and shit, which he copied from the internet. I mean, use your fucking common sense. And then there are these genius, these great intellects who come down to UAE. They just come down. And, you know, what is their strategy? Their strategy is, I will go door to door and put my CV. Yeah, door to door, when you go and give your fucking CV, the receptionist, she sits there, the poor thing, every day, so, madam, is there a job? Yeah, give me your CV. They'll take your fucking CV. Okay, we'll get back to you. And that's what they'll do. They'll take your CV, I'll get back to you. And after you leave, that CV, they remove the staple, they cut the paper, and they recycle this paper. In some other cases, they throw it. I mean, do you actually think that you sending your CV, the receptionist is going to take that CV, run to the general manager or the HR manager. Sir, this amazing guy came down for a job. He's incredible. We must give him a chance for an interview. And then you have these people who send mass emails, forwards. What are you, I mean, where are your brains? Do you seriously think that people are sitting there without any job? Like, how many unsolicited emails do you open? For me, now I'm not an employer, yet I receive hundreds of emails, and I get CVs, and then you get those bigger idiots who will send you'll see 100 names on the two, and they send it to everyone. In fact, this is at least bearable. The ones which are not bearable is like, this female got in touch with me, and she sent me these messages, and, you know, for me, my number is all over the internet. Sends me this message, and she is like, please, lawyer, I'm ready to do anything. Please just help me get a job. I'm ready to do anything. So I was like, okay, fine. Suck my balls. So she's like, excuse me? I said, yeah, give me a blowjob. Suck my balls, I might consider. So, excuse me, this is, how dare you speak to me like that? I said, you told me I'm ready to do anything. I didn't ask you, are you ready to do anything? You told me you're ready to do anything. He's saying, I didn't mean it that way. Okay, then what exactly did you mean? What do you mean by, I am ready to do, in capital, anything? Oh, I was, maybe if there's any work for you, I said, okay, then say like that, I'm ready to do any work for you. So I'll give you the work, complete the work, and then we can talk about it. She said, what is the work? Get me 5 clients, And then after that, I will do your resume for free. No, but where do I search? I said, that's not my fucking problem. You came to me with an offer. You fucking do it. And then she realized she was not getting anywhere. And then there was this one other time, there was this guy. Please, I'm begging you, I'm begging you. He kept writing, I'm begging you, please, sir, I beg you. BG, big letters. I said, okay, fine. Come, beg. Come. He's saying, sir, I didn't understand. Then I replied to him, you said you're going to beg, you're begging me. So beg me. So how can I beg? I said, why, what's the problem? So I'm in Dubai, how can I beg? I said, okay, send me a video of you begging me. Send a video, you're begging, pleading. And me and my wife and everyone will watch it. We will enjoy it. And based on the quality of your begging, I'll give you the service. So I think he understood it doesn't work. Then you get these other religious retards. Lord, I'll pray for you. God always hears my prayers. I tell them that if God hears your prayers, why don't you fucking pray to him instead of coming to me? He should be hearing your prayers, right? So the point I'm trying to tell you here is people don't use your fucking common sense. It just baffles me. I mean, it's like, think about it. You'll put an amazing photograph for Instagram. Amazing photograph. You'll make sure the filter, the look, the angle, everything is perfect. You'll put an amazing photograph of Instagram or Facebook, but you can't invest the same to put something worthwhile on your resume. And then you have these absolutely fucking, disgusting statements. Results oriented, driven professional with 15 years experience. Wow. Fuck. And then people wonder why they're not getting a job. If getting a job was as easy as going door to door, dropping a CV, sending mass emails, copy pasting free information that is on the internet, everyone could fucking get a job here. When will people fucking understand? It's like people actually believe that no one can replace them because they have put years into their craft to be the best. However, when they want to apply for a job, all of a sudden they become experts in resume, experts in interview skills, expert in personal branding. And how do they become experts? They will Google resume format. Oh, this is, I'll download this for $5. Or I'll copy paste this for free. They'll check 10 resumes. They'll see those beautiful words. They'll copy that. An interview. Oh, this is the best one. The questions that people ask. Technical. Okay, fine. I can't comment on anyone's technical skills. But when you have to sell yourself, like the most simple, basic question. Why should I give you this job? Or why do you feel you're the right fit for this job? The typical answer is because I'm hardworking, focused, results oriented. My track record speaks for itself. Oh yeah. And this is the new latest trend. Achieved 30% cost reduction, 50% profit growth, 3.7 million in wastage, 14 million in terms of what? Process improvement. They come up with these amazing numbers. Fuck. It's like, if you're so good that you made 50% profit, 30% cost reduction is like 80%, and another 20% productivity. If you're so valuable to the fucking company, why are they letting you go? Or why did they terminate you? Or why are you fucking unemployed? If you're so good, 30%, 50%. Imagine for a $1 million company, you have helped them generate millions of dollars. You're so great. Then why are you fucking unemployed, man? Shouldn't companies be desperately knocking at your door, begging you, please join us? People assume that they are so intelligent, so smart, that they can fool anyone and convince people to get a job. That's exactly why you're not getting a fucking job, because you're a fucking idiot. That's why you're not getting a job. And last but not the least, getting a job or personal branding is a process. Just like trying to get, you know, trying to get six-pack abs or trying to get a physique, trying to improve sports performance. Even, you know, getting a degree takes 4 years. So if simple things like these take time, you expect getting a job, investing in a personal brand, improving the quality of your life is going to happen by copy-paste information on the internet or watching a video. Oh, wonders never cease. Anyway, just thought I'd share this with you on what kind of idiots get in touch with me online and the magic that they want. So have you experienced any of these idiots who go door to door, sending their CV, dropping in their CV, sending you unsolicited emails, giving you this copy paste, "Dear sir, madam, I hereby send you my resume for your kind perusal," or "Results oriented, driven professional with 15 years experience." Wow. And yes, the latest trend, that is what saved 50% costs, drove the profits by 35%, increased productivity by 19%, brought down the losses to 3.4 billion. Oof. Oh yeah, and the climax, hobbies, watching TV, listening to music, happily married, religion, Christian, and then what is that other one? Holder of a valid UAE driver's license. They apply for manager, but they put their license. Oh yeah, and some of them even smart enough to tell. I worked as what? Sales executive. I was good in filing, faxing, sending emails. Yes, like this latest one I got. The guy was an expert on internet. Knowledge of the internet and MS Office. So anyway, guys, these are the types of clowns I have to deal with on a day-to-day basis. Let me know your thoughts, your questions, suggestions, ideas in the comment section below. It's me signing off. Take care.